Nuclear science and technology in the non-electricity applications continues to play a pivotal role.
The International African Nuclear Conference comes at a time when seven sub-Saharan African countries, including Uganda, have committed to having nuclear energy as part of their energy mix for 2030 to 2037. Officiating at this conference, President Museveni said that Uganda's energy currently needs to be at 100,000 megawatts, which cannot be addressed with available energy sources. Therefore, a need for nuclear energy.
The option of nuclear is a very wise one, and we should not waste time on that, as we normally do with other issues concerning Africa. We should support it because it is the one which is quite reliable. The only problem is the storage of the material, which after it has been used.
He added that nuclear energy will also be very effective in helping the country to combat the effects of climate change.
In Algeria, I saw they are even desalinating seawater to use the water for humans and for plants. I asked them what I need to get the cost of doing that. How much does it cost to desalinate seawater? I hope we should do it. Some people could get us that. Because that would also add to a huge capacity, huge potential. We could be able to immunize ourselves against all these other dangers caused by climate change, causing shortage to fresh water.
The Prime Minister of Uganda, Robinah Nabbanja, revealed government's plans to set up a special skilling center for the nuclear experts at Soroti University.
The country seeks to provide sufficient electricity needed to meet the national government targets set out in the country's vision 2040. This conference, Your Excellency, has therefore come at the right time when the government of Uganda, under your wise leadership, the National Resistance Movement Manifesto, and the National Development Plan 3, that is from 2020, 2021, and 2024, 2025, is pursuing approvals for the construction of a nuclear power generation plant to increase power generation capacity.
Nabbanja says the first nuclear plant is to be set in Buyende district. She has highlighted the benefits of the nuclear plants.
Uganda recognizes the importance of nuclear safety, security, and safeguards in developing nuclear energy for power generation and other peaceful purposes.
The State Minister for Energy, Okasai Opolot, noted that the Minister of Energy is working towards amendment of the Atomic Energy Act 2008 to strengthen the legal regime for nuclear safety, security, safeguards for nuclear material, civil nuclear liability, and maintaining the nuclear institutional framework.
The Atomic Energy Act 2008 is now under review, and my ministry has prepared principles and a draft nuclear bill, which have been presented to the subcommittee of cabinet on nuclear before being sent to parliament to enable us strengthen our preparedness for the implementation of our nuclear power program.
Over 300 stakeholders from the international nuclear community have converged at Speke Resort Munyonyo for the International African Nuclear Business Conference that kicked off on March 14th and will be concluded on March 17th, 2023. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.